Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in PDF. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_022_BIAB where you saved it, or you can go and download this file from the website. If you don't have access into this file, you can go along with your file or sit down and watch the tutorial. Go to the Home tab, go to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Save As icon. This will bring the Save Drawing As dialog box. Pay attention into this area, the file of type. If you plan to open this drawing into earlier version of AutoCAD, go and change the file type. But if you are using AutoCAD 2018, you can leave it as it is. I'm going to change the file of type to AutoCAD 2007 and rename the file to 00_023_DIAB and click the Save button. Zoom in and orbit to see the entire model. Now, when you look at the model, the roof, the wall doesn't touch the roof. Even though the roof starts at the same level where the wall stops, because of the overhanging, the wall doesn't touch the roof. So we need to extrude the wall so that the wall can meet the roof. To do that, let's hide the roof. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and click the Freeze Layer button. Select the roof and the fascia board. Press Escape to get out of the command. Hold down your Shift key and your middle mouse button to hold it. We need to draw additional wall right around this building so that we can add another wall to meet the roof. If you are not in the 3D modeling workspace, go and change the workspace to 3D modeling. Draw this wall. Let's draw a temporal line and we convert the line to walls. To do that, go to the Home tab, Solid Edit panel, and click the down arrow next to Extract Edge. Select the Copy Edge command. Make sure that the cabbage layer is the current layer. Then go to the Selection panel, click the down arrow, and select the Edge filter. Hover your mouse cursor into this edge. Press Enter. At the prompt, specify base point or displacement prompt, click on this area. At the prompt specifying second point or displacement prompt, move the cursor into this area. When you see the object snap, type 3 inches on your keyboard and press Enter. A window appear, give you another option that you can apply to the edge command. Select the copy command again. Select this edge and press Enter. At the specified base point or displacement prompt, select this point and move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 3 inches. Press Enter. Select the copy option again. Continue this process until you get around the building. If you select edge accidentally, go on the type R on your keyboard and press Enter, or you go to the status bar and click the remove option. Select this edge, AutoCAD deselects the edge. Now on any edge that you select, AutoCAD is going to deselect it. To continue, select the add option by typing A, or go on the status bar and select the A option. Now continue to select the edge, press Enter. At the specified base point or displacement prompt, click at this point and move the mouse cursor to the in this direction and type 3 inches on the keyboard. Select the copy option. Press Escape to get out of the copy edge command. Now go to the selection panel and change the selection back to no filter. Go to the Home tab, Solid Edit panel, Poly Solid. At the prompt, specify starting point or type H on your keyboard and press Enter. Type 10 feet. Press Enter. Type W for the width. Press Enter. type 6 inches, press enter. Type O and press enter. At the prompt, select object from, select the temporary line that you just draw. Go to the visual style control and change the visual style to 3D wireframe. Select the poly solid command again. AutoCAD still remember the previous setting that you do. Press enter and select this line. Press enter twice, select this line. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Zoom in into this area. Press enter twice, select this line. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button. Press enter twice, select this line. Press enter twice until you finish all the line that you copy in the with the copy command. Go to the visual style control and change the visual style back to realistic. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. Select the face of this 3D solid and snap it into this vertex. Select the face of this solid, move it back and snap it into this vertex. Select the face of this solid and snap it into this vertex. Select this solid, snap it to this vertex. Select this solid, snap it to this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the edge command. If the edge command is not the default in this icon, click this down arrow and select the copy edge command. Go to the selection panel and click the down arrow. Select the edge filter. Now select this edge, press enter. At the prompt specifying base point or displacement, click this area, then move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 3 inches. Select the copy option again. Make sure that your overlay mode is turned on. Select this edge, press enter. At the prompt specify base point or displacement, select this point, move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 3 inches. Press enter. Select the copy option again. Select this edge, press enter. At specify base point or displacement prompt, click anywhere and move the mouse cursor into this direction, type 3 inches and press enter. Select the copy option again. Zoom in into this area and select this edge. Press enter. At the specifying base point or displacement prompt, click here and move the mouse cursor into this direction. Type 3 inches and press enter. Select the copy option again. Zoom in into this area. Select this edge. Press enter. At specifying base point or displacement prompt, click on this area and move into this direction. Type 3 inches. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the copy edge command. Now go to the visual style control and change the visual style to 2D wireframe. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit so that you can see the edge that we just offset clearly. Go to the home tab, model panel, and select the poly solid command. Look, I still remember the previous setting. Press enter, select this line, press enter twice, select this line, press enter twice, press enter, select this line, press enter, select this line, press enter. Go to the visual style control and change it back to realistic to see the results. Now we need to close this gap. To do that, hold down your shift key and orbit so that you can see the face of this wall, this 3D solid. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. Select this face and snap it to this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Now right click into the drawing area, isolate, and end object isolation. This way will bring any object that you have been used with the hide command. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the four layer button. Now we need to trim this walls, the wall that we drew recently. To do that, go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the isolate command. Select this wall and select the roof. Press enter. Auto guard hide all the other objects except the object that's on the layer of the object you select to isolate. Go to the Home tab, Solid Edit panel, and select the Slice command. Select at the Select Objects to Slice prompt, select the solid. Press Enter. As a specified start point of a slice plan or plan object surface prompt, type S on your keyboard and press Enter, or select the surface option on the status bar. Now select the surface. At the prompt, select slice object to keep or keep both. Click this bottom object. AutoCAD slice the object and delete the unselected one. Select the same command again. Select this object. Press Enter. Type S on your keyboard. Press Enter. Select this surface and click this area. Press Enter to repeat the command. Select this solid. Press Enter. Type S. Press Enter. And select this. Sometimes, if your object goes across the surface that you want to use to slice, the slice command doesn't work. But that is not a big deal. We're going to add and arrange this in a minute. Go to the Home tab, Solid Edit panel, and select the slide command. Select this object, this object, this object. Press Enter. Type S on your keyboard and press Enter. Select the row. Press Enter, Enter, Enter. Now we retain all of the objects. You cannot see the results because we use the keep both option. Now select this, 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 and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the Home tab, Solid Edit panel, and select the slice command. Select this solid, this solid. Press Enter. Type S on your keyboard and press Enter. Select this surface. Click on this area. Hold down your Shift key and your middle mouse button and click on this area. Press Enter to repeat the slice command. Select the solid. Press Enter. Type S. Press Enter. Select the roof surface. Hold down your Shift key and your middle mouse button. Click to deselect this area. Now we need to get rid of these two objects. So here we're going to use a trick, because if we want to slice this with the surface command, we can't, because the object cross more than one surface. So you cannot use two different surfaces to slice one solid. So we need to divide this solid into segments. Then we can use those segments. Later we can link up the segment. Go to the select the solid, hold down your Control Shift and type C on your keyboard. At the specified base point prompt, click on this area. Press Escape to deselect the object. Now go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the Press Pull command. At the prompt, select object or boundary area. Click on this face. Then move the mouse cursor into this direction. Type 40 feet on your keyboard. Press Enter. Select this boundary and move out completely to erase everything. Now we have copied this object into the clipboard, so we need to bring it back so that we can close off this area. To do that, go to the hold down your Control key and type letter V on your keyboard. Because we are using the base point option, at the prompt specifying insertion point prompt, zoom in into this area and click on this vertex. AutoCAD places those objects from its original location. Now select this object and select the roof. Right click into the drawing area, isolate objects. As you can see, this surface isn't cut across the solid. That's why we have that error. So let's draw a temporal line along this face and we use that line to trim the slice the object. Right click the mouse, right click on the UCS, right click on the UCS and select the face option. Hover the mouse cursor into this face and click. Press enter to accept. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. At the specified start point prompt, click on this endpoint. Move your mouse cursor and click on this. Use the endpoint object. Move the mouse cursor and use the endpoint object snap to click. Place the second point. Use the endpoint object snap to place this point again. Press enter to get out of the command. Now select this roof. Right click and isolate hide objects. Hold down your shift key to orbit around. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Extrude this line inside. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the slice command. Select the solid, press enter, type S and press enter. Select this surface, and select this portion. Now select this surface and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Select this line, hit the delete key. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Now go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press P command. At the select object or boundary area prompt, select on this face. Now move this the mouse cursor into this direction and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press enter, press escape. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the slide command. Select the solid, press enter, type S on your keyboard and press enter. Select the surface. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit, then click. So we need to press pull this object back so that it can fit with the other object. To do that, select this object, right click, isolate object, orbit until you see this face. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. Select this face, move it into this direction and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press enter, press escape. Right click into the drawing area, isolate end object isolation. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse orbit around. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded area prompt, click on this face. Now move the mouse cursor until you snap to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the slice command. Select the solid, press enter, type S on your keyboard and press enter. Select this surface, hold down your middle mouse button and select this area. Select the slice command again. Select this solid, press enter, type S on your keyboard and press enter. Select this surface, hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button, select this portion and this, zoom in and select this portion. Now select this surface, right click, isolate object. Now you cannot slice this object with the surface option because this object cross more than one surface, and also this object cross more than one surface. So to do that, let's deal with this one first. If you look at this area, the surface is not cut across the object. So we need to use the press pull command to reduce the length of the object. After we slice it, we can use the press pull command back to bring it back to it normally. Go to the home tab, go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded area prompt, select the this face. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Now we reduce the original length of the object into 1 foot. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the slice command. Select this object, press enter, type S on your keyboard and press enter. Select this surface. AutoCAD at the prompt, select object to select slice object to keep prompt. Select this object. Now go back to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded area prompt, pick on this face. In the previous press, we used 1 foot to reduce the length of the object. To bring the object back to its original length, let's pull by using the press pull with a distance of 1 foot. Type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. The object returned to its original length. This another issue, because there are two surfaces in this area and you cannot use these two surfaces to slice this one object. To do that, let's draw a temporal line. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 3D polyline. Select this corner, this corner, and this corner. Press enter. Select this surface, this surface, right click, isolate, hide object. Now select the 3D polyline that you just drew. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Extrude this line into this direction. Now go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the slice command. Select the solid, press enter, type S on your keyboard and press enter. Select this surface and select this portion. Now select the surface and hit the delete key on the keyboard. Also select this line and hit delete key on the keyboard. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. This will bring all your objects. Now select one of the gable that we just created. Right click into the drawing area, select similar. This will select all the solid with the same properties. Right click, isolate, isolate object. AutoCAD hide all the other objects except this object. Now go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the union command. Select all these objects and press enter. AutoCAD unites all these objects to one object. Again, we need to close some of this area, these gaps. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. Click on this face and snap to this vertex. Repeat the same command. Click on this face and snap to this vertex. Hold down your middle mouse button and orbit around to see if there is any gap. Yes, there is one into this area. Now select this face and snap to this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the union command. Select this. Press enter. Now orbit around and select the press pull command. Select this face and press pull it into this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the unisolate command. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. At the select source object prompt, select this 3D world. At the select destination object prompt, select this gable and zoom in into this area and select this other gable. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save icon. All right, in this tutorial, you learn how to create a gable and attic wall to fill in the space between the wall height and the roof height. In the next tutorial, we'll start to create a surface or over angle. If you found this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow up on the tutorial in this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.